Hey YouTube, let's build this today. I'm going to be using bricks to build this effect. It's a pointer follower effect. As you can see, it's following my pointer. And when you hover over something that needs to be clicked, indicates the user like so. Hover out becomes small again to become a normal pointer follower. Okay, let's build this in bricks. Let's go. Here I am in my bricks builder environment. But before we start, we need to grab some codes from a open source script. It was provided by Cuberto Mouse Follower script, and it's got a pretty nice documentation here, and it's pretty cool. And we will be grabbing some codes snippets from here, and we will install it into our bricks builder. Okay, this page, Cuberto Mouse Follow, I will list the URL for this page in my description down below the video. Okay, so you could easily find this page. All right, the first thing we need to do is grab a couple of code snippets, and this script is leveraging the GSAP library, by the way. So we're going to be using not the npm method, but the cdn method, which is quite much easier for us to implement into bricks. So let's first copy the CSS belongs to this script along with the JavaScript that's given. So copy. Let's go over to our bricks settings area, custom code, go under the header script. Right before the closing head tag, let's put that in there. Paste it, go back to the GitHub page, and this is leveraging GSAP, by the way, for some of the animation that's happening in the mouse. So instead of copying everything here, just grab this one, top two lines, source there, and ignore these three lines below. And let's go back to the header script area and paste that in. Okay, step one is done. So let's save the settings. Okay, there's one more set of codes that we need to copy. Scroll down to about this area, and let's grab all of these guys and come back to bricks, and let's paste it this time in body for the scripts area. Okay, oh, before I do that, I need to, because this is JavaScript, we need to put it into the script tag. Open and close it like so, and then paste it in between them like so. Okay, let's save settings. Let's have a quick look what it looks like in the front end. Okay, right now there's no follower. Let's refresh. There. So we have that happening, and when you scroll over the image, nothing's happening. So we want to do that effect when we hover over the image so that user know that they should click on this image to launch the light box. Okay, now we want to apply the effect over the image when the user hovers over. Okay, so let's select the image. I created a class, as you can see, and you want to make sure the class is activated, and then go to the attributes tab. And you want to create a new attribute. So you want to type in data hyphen cursor text. This is all in the documentation under the Cuberto GitHub page that I mentioned before. So that's where I got this from. And then for the value, what text is going to be inside the circle when you hover? So I'll say click to zoom. Let's save it. Okay, template is saved. Let's go to the front end now. Right now it's not working, so refresh. It should, there, it's working. It says click to zoom. As you can see, when I hover out, and this should apply to all of the images because apply to all of the same classes here, like so. And when you click on one, Lightbox launches. Okay, so here's some slight customization to these following pointers. So as you can see, if when I move around, it might be too close. Let's change that a little bit. So let's go back to our script here and scroll down to about speed. Let's change that to, I don't know, 2, so we could really see exaggerated. Okay, let's refresh the front end. Okay, as you can see, that's what happens. So you get that kind of customization, but let's change that. That's too much. Speed here. Maybe let's do 1.8. Maybe that might be better. Save it, and let's see what else can we do. Let me refresh that. Oh yeah, that's much better. I like that. So let's try to skew this little circle when you move it back and forth. Right now it's just perfectly circle. So let's look for skewing. Now it's 0. So let's put it to 5. What that would look like. Saved in the back end, refreshed. Okay, as you can see, the follower. It gets skewed when I move it, and when I move it faster, I don't know if you can see that, but it gets more skinny. It gives it more cool animation effect, actually. So I'm going to leave that. I kind of like it. And here, as you can see, on this effect, the circle kind of gets wiggly woogly, whatever. Let's try to change that too. So that should be skewing text, such on the 2. Let's just put that to 0, see what that does. Save, go back to the front end. Okay, see, it doesn't skew anymore. Yeah, so I hope that gave you some ideas to play around with some of the values. So now there's a bug here. If you scroll over to the header section, the follower disappears. So how do we fix that? So let's do that right now. To fix this, we need to bring the z-index value to the highest point possible so that the follower is above the header. So how do we do that? So let's go to GitHub, scroll back up, and look for their CSS, which is right here. And let's just grab this URL. Open up a new tab, paste that in there, and let's grab their CSS code. And we need to modify the code a little bit. So let's launch our Visual Studio code here. And then let's format this so we could read this better. Go with that. Okay. So what we need to do is look for the cursor here, z index. So MF cursor, so that's what we're looking for. And we want to change the z index to the highest value possible. So let's do that to just in case 99999. So that's super high. So let's grab these codes and go back to our custom CSS area. I have a lot of custom CSS here, so you may have something different. So here, I want to place it there. Okay, it's right underneath everything. Where is it? Oh, here. Let me comment it. Just comment it there, and this is the cursor effect. Okay, and go down. We need to remove that CSS link here in the header script. So delete this line because now we are using locally or within our own template. So we don't need the external CSS file anymore. So save settings and let's check it out on the front end. Refresh. There, No, there you go. So it's fixed like so. Okay, so what else can we do? Let's change the color of the follower. Okay, so let's go into our custom CSS area. Let's go look for our, here's the cursor effect. Let's add in a color. Let's put it, I guess, right here. Why does this keep jumping down there? Weird. Let's put a color. I want to add an orange. I already know my hex value, so it will be EB5837. It's a nice brand orange color that I like from them. And let's save the settings. Go up to the front end and refresh. Should be orange. There you go. And if you scroll down, it becomes orange as well. Yeah, so that's it for this tutorial. I hope you enjoy. Have fun with it and feel free to play around with the values that's in the given script.